Hello everybody, it's Delilah and welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be my second pregnancy update of my third pregnancy. So currently I am 13 weeks and 2 days pregnant. I meant to film this last week already because it's been a month since I last filmed one of these. My first one was at 8 weeks. And I mean, lots happens in a month of pregnancy, and we are officially, I guess, in the second trimester. So this is gonna be kind of a first trimester recap. I'm gonna answer some of your questions. I'm gonna go over how I've been feeling. We saw the baby in an ultrasound. I've had doctor's appointments. I've heard the baby's heartbeat. And there's just been a lot of development that's happened in the last month or so. So without further ado, let's get into it. So by now the news is officially out. I announced it this week, although by the time you see this video, it will already have been a while since the news has been out, but it feels so good to finally not be keeping this a secret anymore. It was a beautiful time keeping it a secret, keeping it to ourselves, having this as our own little thing that no one else knew about, and just sharing it with family and friends, and it was a very special time. But I'm so happy to finally be able to talk about it to you, to share how I've been feeling, to not hide this anymore. I feel like you haven't seen the true me for the last few months because I just have not been feeling good. And I've been trying to hide the fact that I haven't been feeling good. So let's start with the basics. I'm 13 weeks and 2 days pregnant right now. Baby is the size of a peach, which is insane to me. That's insane. Baby just went through a crazy growth spurt, and these facts just fascinate me more and more with each pregnancy. It just blows me away. In the last 3 weeks, baby has doubled in size. Crazy. So I'm just gonna read the update that my pregnancy app gives me. This is the Pregnancy Plus app that I use. This is what baby looks like right now. I don't know why it's all like weird and multicolored on screen. It does not look like that in real life. This is what baby looks like right now, which is a big step up from what it was the last few weeks, because in the last few weeks, you can see there's been a lot of development happening. Crazy. So this week it says your baby is now twisting and turning all the joints in the body and continually moving around inside your uterus. Your baby's skin is very translucent at this point and all the tiny veins in the body are visible. The lungs continue to develop and your baby is practicing breathing with the amniotic fluid on a regular basis. Your baby may already be sucking its thumb by now. Your peach-sized baby can now frown, grimace, and your baby's reflexes are becoming stronger and more frequent. Reading these weekly updates, it just blows me away. It's so crazy, the stuff that my body is doing right now. Like, this is inside my body. So, how have I been feeling? Exhausted, completely and utterly exhausted. I have not felt this tired since my very first pregnancy. I don't remember feeling this tired in my second pregnancy, but in my first, I took a lot of naps, and then I was able to take naps because I didn't have anyone else to take care of. But now I have two toddlers running around all the time. I gotta be awake when they're awake. I can't just go take a nap. I will say though, right now Zach is at home and he doesn't have a lot of work going on, so he is able to help so much. I am so grateful that all my usual duties I'm able to pass on to Zach, and he can help carry the load with me. And we can do this together. He's able to help me out so much. He takes the kids every once in a while to go run errands so I can just have a quiet moment to work, to think, to rest. I've been resting a lot, been giving myself a lot of grace because I just cannot do everything that I used to do. I just can't. I have no motivation at all, which is why it's been so hard in the last few months to create content. And if you follow me on Instagram, you may have noticed that I haven't been as present on there just because I haven't had any creative motivation to take photos. I've just been laying on the couch a lot, trying not to throw up, trying to gather the energy to get up and make supper and do things that need to get done. And I've become somewhat of a night owl, which is just crazy. It's so strange because I'm generally someone who really loves waking up early in the morning. I love to go to bed a little bit earlier, wake up earlier, have that time to myself in the morning. But lately, I'm staying up a little bit later because after the kids go to bed is kind of like my only time that I get to myself. And for whatever reason, I seem to have a little bit more energy later at night, which is just so opposite of what I normally am. And I cannot get out of bed before 8. That is so bad. I'm like embarrassed to say that, but I cannot get myself out of bed before 8. I'm telling myself this is only temporary. Usually for myself, it's around the 14-15 week mark that I start to gain my energy back. I start to feel better, less nauseous. So I am hoping and praying that in the next couple weeks, I feel way better. If you can tell, I am so out of breath. This has been a more recent thing. I mean, I've been out of breath this whole pregnancy, but especially lately, especially in the last week, I've noticed that I just, I went up 3 flights of stairs and I was panting. It's bad. It's really bad. I'm talking and I'm like out of breath trying to, it's bad. As far as morning sickness goes, in the beginning, I was sick a lot more when I first woke up. Now I'm not sick when I first wake up, thank the Lord. I'm hungry and I eat and it's all good. And it's more so towards like the afternoon and evenings that I start feeling a lot more sick, not so good. Even after lunch, I start to feel that slump. And I think a big reason for that is I've noticed a direct correlation between me sleeping, like how much sleep I get and how much rest I get and how I feel. So if I get a lot of rest and I feel really rested and good and energized, I feel better the next day. If I have a really bad night's sleep, I feel really bad the next day. Headaches also seem to come along with that. I've been having a lot more headaches this pregnancy than ever before. They're not like really, really bad, like not migraine level, but just headaches, like really annoying. Hard to think about anything else other than the fact that my head hurts. Also, in the last few days, this is a new thing. I've started to feel a more frequent need to pee, especially when there's like someone, like one of my kids sitting on my lap or whatever else, like I'm bending over, like there's pressure on my stomach a little bit. I notice a very strong need to pee frequently, which is new. That's usually something that happens towards the end of my pregnancy, and I don't feel like I should be at that stage yet, but I am. I mean, I guess baby's the size of a peach and my womb has to be bigger than that. Plus it's filled with amniotic fluid. It's filled with a placenta that's growing in there as well. So like things are growing, getting bigger, and there's more pressure on my bladder. Also, a new development, which is kind of like shocking to me. My breasts have been slightly sore and tender, and I swear they've grown. I am shocked by this because I am still breastfeeding my son, and I thought in my last pregnancy with my son, I didn't have any of this, and I thought it was because I was breastfeeding a lot of that time, Eloise. I was breastfeeding Eloise while pregnant. And the same thing this time around, I'm breastfeeding Theo. We're getting close to the end of our nursing journey, but I was still nursing throughout the night. Like I was still nursing a fair amount for a while. And so I was not expecting any breast growth, any breast tenderness whatsoever, but I'm definitely experiencing that. And Zach noticed it too. I don't think I've grown like a full cup size or anything. I only wear bralettes, so they're very forgiving in that area. They're different. They're different, which is another symptom that really makes me wonder if this is a girl pregnancy. Just knowing myself, my past pregnancies, how I felt with a girl pregnancy and a boy pregnancy, comparing the two, I'm kind of leaning toward girl at this point. And a lot of other people are too. And I swear, I have been feeling movements already. I am positive. I know what they feel like. I know my body quite well, and I've got a lot of digestive issues and stuff, so I know what digestion feels like, what air bubbles feel like very well. And the flutters I'm feeling are very distinct, very different from air bubbles. I felt my son move at 11 weeks. I'm 12 weeks this time, and so I'm pretty positive I've been feeling things, and especially yesterday, I was mostly sitting on the couch, relaxing, and really noticing a lot of movement. Little tiny, tiny kicks, little flutters, which is so special and so exciting. So we had an ultrasound at 9 weeks. I think it was like 9 weeks and 3 days or something, and baby was measuring one day ahead, which is awesome. Like, it's perfect, right on track. So the official due date is July 11th, which is 2 days after Eloise's birthday. So I am just praying that this baby does not come on Eloise's birthday. I want them to have their own birthdays. Just trying to rest in God's plan. I know that he has a plan. He's got this all figured out. And I'm just resting in that and trusting in that and praying for a June baby. Because I really just want them to have some time in between their birthdays. I was really nervous going into the ultrasound. With each pregnancy, it just gets a little bit more nerve-wracking and a little more scary, but everything went very well, like very well. One of the best ultrasounds I've had. I've had really good ultrasound experiences. I've had really bad ultrasound experiences, and this ultrasound technician actually let me film some of the live ultrasound, which I've never been able to do before. We are on our way to the first ultrasound for baby number 3. I am extremely nervous. With each pregnancy, the first ultrasound gets more and more scary, especially after the miscarriage. Just because now I'm so much more aware of what can go wrong and what can happen. Praying for the best, obviously. Praying that we see a little baby moving and wiggling around and a fluttering heartbeat. Husbands aren't allowed in, so it's just me.
Not worthy.
See you in a few minutes.
Yeah, I guess. Have fun.
I will. Look at this. This is our little baby. Look, you can even see arms and legs.
Oh yeah.
It's so cute. I'm excited.
It's real. It's happening.
And you can see in the ultrasound baby like kind of kicking and moving and wiggling. There was one point, I didn't catch it on camera, but there was one point the baby actually like waved at me, and it was just so special and so relieving. I just felt such a huge sigh of relief after that ultrasound. The heartbeat was 170 beats per minute. Yeah, everything went really well. So then a week later, I had a follow-up prenatal, which was my second prenatal appointment. All the blood work looked good. Everything from the ultrasound looked great. There was no like questions or concerns. Everything was going really well. I even got to hear the baby's heartbeat. She checked, it didn't take long, and she found it, and the heartbeat was, I think she said 165 beats per minute, so very close to that 170. And it's just such a beautiful sound, hearing your baby's heartbeat for the first time, especially at this stage, because you can't feel anything yet. So I think I was about 10 weeks when I heard the heartbeat for the first time, and it was just so beautiful. I had my third prenatal booked in 2 weeks. So I should be able to update you in the next pregnancy update, how that went, what baby's heartbeat is like now, how everything's going, but I think everything is going really, really well. Eloise keeps saying that this baby is a girl, and she is so convinced that this baby is a girl that she literally refers to the baby as she. She calls it she, like she's so dead convinced, and I keep trying to tell her like this baby might not be a girl, it might be a boy. And no, she's very, very convinced it's a girl. So we'll see. It's kind of weird because all my other pregnancies, everyone has always voted boy. Everyone's always guessed boy. This is the first time anyone has ever even thought maybe it'll be a girl. So it's kind of strange, kind of fun. So with that, I'm gonna do a little belly shot, and then I'm gonna get into some questions. I went on Instagram and I got you guys to ask me anything that you're wondering about, because like this has been a secret for so long. I'm sure you've got some questions for us, so I've got them here. do the belly shot first. Currently my outfits are whatever fits and whatever's comfortable. So I have about 3 pairs of pants that still fit. And my outfits make no sense, but they're comfy, so I wear them. Here we are. Baby bump number 3. It feels really big. I don't know if this is like normal or if this is exceptionally large. A lot of it is still like squish and stuff from my last pregnancy. Like you can see, there's still a lot of squish going on, but there is a hard little lump inside there and lots of room for baby to grow. Okay, there's a question for Zach here. I think Zach and I are gonna do a sit down Q&A, a lot about pregnancy and about life in general. Soon, we'll do that soon. So I'll get you guys to ask some more questions then. How do you know when you are ready for your next child? Honestly, I wasn't even 100% ready to be pregnant again with this pregnancy, but at the same time, I wanted it so bad. It's so hard to explain. With my other two, I had the craziest baby fever. I wanted a baby so bad. Both times. This time was a little different and we waited longer and I was waiting for that feeling to come back and it didn't. But at the same time, I felt ready. I just kind of knew. I don't know. It's really hard to explain. It might be different for everyone, I'm sure. Are you going to find out the gender or wait? I don't know. I always said with this pregnancy, we would find out the gender, but now that we're here, now that we have a boy and we have a girl, I don't know. I'm scared to find out because I feel like if I find out, it might almost ruin it for me in a way. I know Zach does not want to find out, but he respects my decision if it's something I really want to do. I'm kind of thinking we might just keep it a surprise again. Just because we have a boy, we have a girl. I know how beautiful it is to be a mother of a girl. I know how beautiful it is to be a boy mom. Both are amazing. How did Eloise react? And does she understand it's more this time around? I did recently share me telling Zach and me telling the kids and their reactions. So if you want to see that, I'll leave that linked here and below as well. I think she knows more this time. She realizes there's a baby in my tummy. She comes and talks to the baby sometimes. She wants to give the baby lots of kisses. It's really sweet. And we recently had a new addition to the family. My nephew was recently born and the kids have just been absolutely obsessed with him. They're just so sweet and loving. And every time we see them, Eloise just wants to hold her little cousin and Theo just, he just is so curious and interested. And so I think Eloise seeing an actual baby, like seeing her aunt be super pregnant and then all of a sudden have a baby, kind of visualizes it for her. She can understand it a little bit more. Is there anything about pregnancy that still surprises you or catches you off guard now that it is your third baby? Not really. The only thing that really surprises me still is just reading about how baby is developing and the kind of stuff that it can do already and the stuff my body is doing. Like I know all this stuff. I've been through it before, but just reading it and going through it again is crazy. But even though this pregnancy is so much different than my last two pregnancies, it still feels so much the same. I feel generally just really gross in the first trimester, and it's a very distinct feeling. Like a very distinct, I am pregnant feeling I felt with all my pregnancies. So far, nothing has really caught me off guard yet. How long was the trying to conceive process? 2 months. First month, nothing. Second month, we did conceive. And this is the longest it's ever taken, which again is something I'm incredibly grateful for. I know how blessed we are to be able to conceive quickly. But I will say the first month that I got a negative was really a very humbling like kick in the pants because I took it for granted. I never could understand, and I still can't understand or relate to people who try for so long to conceive. My heart just absolutely breaks for them because knowing how I felt in that month between the negative and the positive, it felt so hopeless, which I feel like I don't have a right to say because it was only a month, but like it was very humbling. It was very humbling. Do you have a vague idea what you might name baby Lepke number 3? A vague idea? Yes. We actually managed to find a boy name that we both like, which is a huge step in the right direction for us because for the longest time we just couldn't decide on anything. Theodore was literally the only name that Zach has ever liked. So that's why Theodore is named Theodore. So we finally have settled on a first name for a boy. Still don't have a second. And for a girl, we're a bit up and down. There's a number of names that we love, but to narrow it down is tricky. What's your birth plan? I don't have a birth plan yet. I don't really have a plan. I know I'm gonna give birth in a hospital if we make it to the hospital on time. I'm going with a doctor. Getting in with midwife is literally impossible here, and I feel very fortunate that I have a doctor that I really love. The hospital I'm gonna give birth in is actually new, so I'm excited about that. But other than that, that's kind of my plan so far. I don't really have one. I haven't planned anything, I haven't bought anything, I haven't looked at any baby things, I haven't done anything in preparation for baby at all. And that's mostly because I've felt so sick and unmotivated and tired. But also it just feels so early in the pregnancy. Like for a long time it just didn't really feel real. Didn't feel like I was pregnant. And it's only kind of starting to sink in now. I guess we've got a lot of planning and prepping to do in the next 6 months. That's gonna be it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed it, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And do subscribe if you wanna follow along on this pregnancy journey. Make sure to hit that bell button as well so that you're notified as soon as my videos go live so that you don't miss out on anything new. I'll be putting out hopefully a lot of good baby content and vlogs and real life stuff, and I'm just so excited to share this journey with you. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye guys.